If you remember yesterday, I shared with you that St. Anthony's tongue and his larynx are preserved. They've never corrupted. So St. Anthony's tongue is not corrupted. So you have to listen to the liturgy. Sometimes they put funny things in there, like the gospel verse there when it says, like choice silver is the just man's tongue. So that's the church being a little tongue-in-cheek, pardon the pun. You know, when we say our prayer to St. Anthony each day, we keep using this phrase, O holy St. Anthony, gentlest of saints. Second part of prayer, we talk about him being, O gentle and loving St. Anthony. And yet for the past 3 days, I've been talking about Anthony's strength, right? His power of his preaching, the power of his voice, the power to convert others, the power to work miracles. And yet we call him gentle, the gentlest of saints. Now, St. Anthony was a pretty strong person. He was strong physically, but he was also strong morally. He was strong in what was right and what was wrong. He did not compromise. One time after St. Francis's death, all the brothers had gathered with the Pope because there was problems with their new director, Brother Elias. And Brother Elias was banned from attending the meeting. And during the meeting, a bunch of the brothers burst into the meeting carrying Brother Elias on their shoulders. And who was St. Anthony mad? He went over and he grabbed Elias by his hood and dragged him before the Pope and threw him down there. And then Elias got punished. Don't mess with Anthony. And another time he was invited to come and speak at a conference with priests and the bishop, the archbishop, and all these priests. Well, the archbishop had some issues with his morality. And Anthony got up to the pulpit and had no problem telling the bishop like it was, calling him out on his bad behavior. Now, the archbishop was converted and did penance as a result of Anthony's preaching. But Anthony had no problem speaking the truth with firmness, but he also spoke it with love. His preaching was powerful, it was strong, but there was a gentleness to it too. When somebody was corrected by Anthony, there was so much love in that correction that it made them want to convert. There was so much gentleness. Let's just say he mixed the medicine with a lot of honey. So that it brought people to convert. They wanted to convert because there was love that was motivating the correction. Because he loved that archbishop and wanted that archbishop to come to conversion, he was straightforward with him, but with love. And Anthony is incredibly gentle. As I mentioned, he worked miracles on earth, but he's most known for his miracles after his death. So many miracles that have won for him so many devotees. People go to him for everything and anything. Sometimes their prayers are rather disrespectful. Like that, Tony, Tony, come around, something's lost and can't be found. I'm sure you heard that. It's kind of a disrespectful way to speak to him, but he doesn't care. He does it anyway because he cares so much for people. He knows it's not about him. You know, St. Anthony, on this day, we can't do it because of COVID-19. Had we not had COVID-19, I would have given you all bread today. I wouldn't have baked it. I went out and bought it, but I can't bake. But if I baked bread, I would have been poisoning you. But today is the day you give out bread. Why? Well, about 30 years after St. Anthony's death, while they were building the basilica, one of the women in town, her son drowned. And when they finally fished out the boy's body, the mother was just in tears and she went to the tomb of St. Anthony and she said, give my son back to life. If you give him life back, if you raise him from the dead, St. Anthony, I will give pound for pound of my son's weight, cornmeal to the poor. And the boy was resurrected from the dead. And so whatever her boy weighed, that she took that amount of weight and cornmeal and she gave it to the poor. 600 years later after that, this baker, she got locked out of her shop. This is something so simple. Things Anthony loves to do. Like she couldn't get into her shop. And she couldn't get into the bakery. And so this guy went to go get tools to break down the doors. And she said, St. Anthony, if you get me inside my bakery without me having to break down these doors, I will give bread to the poor every year on your feast day. And she gently pushed the doors open and began the feast, the celebration that on his feast day, bread is distributed to the poor. Something as simple as like opening the door for somebody. That's his gentleness. That's his care. The hearing the prayer of this mother whose son had drowned. Yes, he cared for them, but he also cared about the poor. So in their love for the poor, he rewarded them with this miracle from heaven. Now, he does run God's lost and found office in heaven, right? He's in charge of the lost and found. He's got about 50 secretaries looking for lost things, right? And this came when he was alive. He had a book of the Psalms that he loved. He used to teach from, and one of the novices who left the order took it and stole the book on him. And he prayed, and that novice had a change of heart and brought the book back. And it became this thing that if something's lost, St. Anthony will pray for you, he'll find it for you. I mean, how many of us have stories of things we lost, and we prayed to St. Anthony, we found it miraculously? I mean, story after story after story after story, whether it be eyeglasses or keys or books or this or that or parking space, St. Anthony tends to come around with it. Not too long ago, my mother was babysitting my nephew a couple of years ago. He must have been about 6 at the time, and it was time for him to go to bed, and he couldn't find the little hat to one of his Lego men. And so my mother took this as an opportunity to teach him devotion to St. Anthony, to pray to St. Anthony. Well, they couldn't find that hat for nothing, even though they prayed to St. Anthony. And my mother's saying stuff like, well, maybe he took the day off, you know. And as Ryan was crying, going to bed, couldn't find the hat for his little guy, my brother walked in the door, looked down and said, oh, is this what he's looking for? Simple as that. Something as simple as a part of a toy for a child, St. Anthony's attentive to. This is the beauty of his heart from heaven. You know, St. Anthony is also the patron of mail. Did you know that? He's the patron of mail. See, there was this lady. Her husband went off to another country to work, and she hadn't heard from him in months. So she wrote him a letter. And she put the letter in an envelope, and she put it in the hand of the statue of St. Anthony. Put it in his hands, in the statue. The next day she came back, she saw the envelope was still there. I guess she thought St. Anthony would deliver it. And she was crying because the letter was still there. The friars walked up to her and said, what is that letter in his hands? So she tells them the story. She wrote a letter to her husband. She gave it to St. Anthony. And the friar said, we tried all night to get that out of his hands. We couldn't get that letter out of the hands of the statue. Well, the woman went up and she took the letter out, and it was a letter from her husband telling her that he's okay, he'll be home soon. And that's why many people will write on their envelopes, S-A-G, St. Anthony Guide. He even cares about our mail. You know, St. Anthony is oftentimes pictured with a lily. It's interesting. This one doesn't happen with a lily, but you usually see him holding a lily. Oh, he does have the lily? Okay. I couldn't see it from here. And the reason why is because somebody on his feast day decided to put a lily in his hands. And the lily was there in the statue for a couple of days. And then one day they came in and the lily sprung more flowers out of nowhere. Something simple, like flowers. This is the gentleness of Anthony's heart. And finally, not only is he gentle towards humanity, so kind towards us, but Jesus found him so gentle and so kind that he decided one day, when St. Anthony was nearing death, to appear to Anthony as a child. That Jesus trusted Anthony so much that he laid in his arms like a little child. Just rested in his arms for Anthony to contemplate the mystery of God becoming man, the beautiful mystery, the gentleness of Christ, the beautiful mystery of the humility of God, the beautiful mystery of the fact that God so loved us and became one of us, like a helpless child. And in the gentle arms of St. Anthony there, the child Jesus sat in his arms, embraced him. That's why the image of St. Anthony with the Christ child is always there. Because God found him so gentle that he wanted Anthony to hold him as a child. It's the beauty of his gentleness even towards God. We celebrate an incredible saint today. This beautiful saint of the church where every land, every nation, every diocese has a parish named after him. The devotions to him are just amazing because St. Anthony never fails. Never fails. He may have died 800 years ago, or 910 years, to 890 years to be exact, ago today. However, Anthony never left in so many ways. He never stopped caring. From his place in heaven, he's done more than he ever did on earth, still leading souls to Christ, still showing his gentleness and care for everyone, still to this day, loving us and loving God. So we bring to him today our petitions, our prayers, and we ask the gentle St. Anthony, in the strength of his love, to hear us, to answer us, to be our companion through this life, and see us safely home to the glory of heaven. May God bless you and Mary keep you.